our job.
It'd be the background.
I'm always interested in, like, what's next for Pasifika people in the Western world. Like, you know, we've come to New Zealand. Our parents have come to New Zealand. We've started from scratch again. Then the next generation builds on that. Builds on the houses our parents bought. And then we start getting into business slowly. And then our kids will probably take over those businesses. You know, like, what I mean? Like, when are we going to, like, you said that we've gone into places now. We're sitting at the table now, huh?
Yeah.
But for me, like, is that, I don't think it should stop. It doesn't stop there, huh?
No.
We keep moving.
Keep leveling up.
Are you alluding to, like, what's the apex point? How far are we going to go?
Yeah.
So we're going to have, so,
I mean,
what's the end game then? When are we going to have our first politician, prime minister?
I think it's just like for us to kind of like own our destiny, you know what I mean? Like, so we think about our time in New Zealand. I think primarily our measure is still based on finding success outside of our world, you know what I mean? So it's like, so if we make it to be CEO of like a big company, we've cracked it. If we get to be a minister in parliament, we've cracked it. But I think it's about trying to create our own lanes, you know what I mean? So if we think about business, like for example, Shopify, you know, you can crack it on Shopify now, work from home, sell whatever you've created, have a massive audience for it. But who gets the biggest cut of that? You know what I mean? Like, I mean, you get something to live off it, but like, you're also contributing to the creators of Shopify.
That's the next level I'm talking about.
You want to be Shopify. You want to shape how humans behave. Like, you want to create the platforms like that people gravitate towards. So you want to be the Facebook or the Instagram.
The trendsetter.
So, I mean, I think our creativity is out there, you know, like, for real. Like, I mean, even Moana, you know, that they come to Moana to get the story for Disney, you know what I mean? And then that has exposed Pacific culture to, like a global audience. If, you know, if it wasn't, or if they weren't aware before, through Disney, they have access to that. But, you know, they being anyone who's non-Pacific, but who benefited the most out of that financially? Disney. You know what I mean? So I mean, you got fellas like Stallone, for example, you know, he's making his movies like Take Home Pay and Three Wise Cousins and all of that kind of stuff, you know, like that's the entry point. You know what I mean? I mean, there's entry points before that, but like, that should be, he's the level up. Then what's the next level up? You know, it's like
owning the studios. Tyler Perry styles.
At the same time, I think, like, for us to get to that level, we've got to sacrifice a little bit. I feel we're going to sacrifice a little bit of what Pacifica is about. Like, when I think about like CEOs and Disney and all those corporate, they're based on an individual sort of, you know. They're sort of like
doggy dog.
They don't bring each other up. They just bring themselves up, sort of thing. Build something. Whereas us, our culture is not. It's probably the opposite. And how can we survive in that Western world when Western world is like that? You know what I mean?
I think it's like that's, it's, like I said, it's the measure. So for us, it's like, for us to be happy, what does that look like? You know, does it mean that we have $1 million? Or does that mean that everyone eats? You know what I mean? Or maybe it's somewhere in between. You know what I mean? Like, so it's trying to look at things from how we value it. You know, like, it's funny, like, one of the things we're working on at work at the moment is we're trying to just encourage communities of young Māori and Pacific in particular to test their kind of entrepreneurial creativity. You know, so, bro, we've been working with the SysCat. You know, and like looking to partner with her work up in Te Manawa, up in Northwest. You know, to like give our kids access to tools that can bring their creativity to life in a way that they can put it to market and test it out and say, like, oh, yo, do people want this? You know, I think of people like Poetic, you know, bro, that guy, he grinds hard and he's still doing, like, he does all of it. He does the flea market. He does the online. You know what I mean? Like, so there's like heaps of people out there, like, who have that creativity that people want, and people beyond our communities too. You know, so I think that's the key, is that, like, lots of people come and tell, or look to our creative capacity, and then invite it to their mainstream businesses and pay for it accordingly. Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah.
But then that keeps it as an individual thing, yeah, you know. So if we create the communities around business and change the model up, where it's like, rather than competitive, they're like, you know, whoever's the best wins here, that's, they're like, bro, like, how do we help each other out to, like, all eat better? Yeah, you know what I mean? And then, like, if we share the audience, if we share the kind of like what you're doing with WESWES, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
When you got all these contributors, you share a platform, and then wider audience sees it, you know. But if you just keep it to yourself and you just no, this is gold. Yeah, we're waiting for it one day to blow up. You know what I mean? Like, then maybe it does or maybe it doesn't. But there's through collaboration, you know, there's more chance that, you know, people are gonna see your stuff, you know. So I think, yeah, just trying to look at, like, what are the models that we invest our energy and time into. And looking at it from, like, I don't know if it's near the ecosystem versus ecosystem kind of model, you know, and just trying to think of all the examples we have when we come here of how we look after each other. Similar to, like, you know, when we're back in the islands, you know, there's ways that, you know, like, we all contribute a little bit of something, and those who don't, you know, we kind of look at them a little bit side-eyed, you know, you know what I mean? Like, but the point of it is that, like, you know, like, because I remember growing up with that thing, like, bro, it's islanders, we can't get rich. Because, like, even if we win the lottery, it's like, you know, to everybody. And then, but not also not viewing that as a bad thing, because I think we grow up with this idea that, like, that's a bad thing, you know, that, you know, when people are, like, queuing up for something that you have, that's like, oh, bro, he's a leech. But, like, it's like, what do we share? Like, it doesn't have to be money. It's like, gee, I'll share knowledge, or I'll share the platform, or I'll share, you know, that kind of thing. So
I'm glad you're talking about this, because, you know, I think, like, you know, we can't transcend that, because how the Balangis do it and how we do it. So I think there's a clash there, but you've just told me, like, or told us, like, nah, we can build our own path, our way.
Yeah, yeah.
And we can live up with them.
And still using that old kind of traditional.
Yeah, yeah. And bring each other up.
Yeah.